Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's video I want to show you how to build your own pendant style aquarium lighting that is highly customizable and for about $7. If this isn't something you're looking for, I have also covered fluorescent lights, high powered LEDs, and low powered LED strips in a couple of different ways. I will leave links to those in the description below. For this project, I was simply interested in trying something different on my 375 gallon. Up until this video, I have been using my typical light strip design, which is great, but I've been interested in pendant lighting as of late, so I wanted to give them a shot. So let's jump right into the build and then I'll show you some variations of the light in action. To make the pendant, we need something shaped almost like a lampshade. Luckily, it's the season for plastic planters around here, and they're cheap. When you turn these upside down, they look just like a lampshade. These plastic planters come in almost every size, shape, design, and color that you can imagine. I picked up a few to try out. Given that they are only $3 each, this is totally affordable. You'll want to stick with a bell-shaped planter simply because they will distribute the light out more. You'll also want to pick a size that is appropriate to your aquarium. Really, it will come down to whatever you think will look proportionate. The downside with these is I didn't like the color, so I decided to paint the inside of the planter with a glossy white to make it a more reflective surface for the light. And then the outside black. I did a couple coats of each color. I had a few cans of spray paint left over from another project, so I didn't add this into my overall cost. Plus, painting these are entirely optional. All I needed now was a lamp socket, and these are actually what inspired this build in the first place. I was at a local dollar store and I saw these for $3 each. I also saw them on eBay and Amazon, as well as local hardware stores, all for around the same price. So these are actually pretty common. This one came with an on and off switch, which would come in really handy for easy access to turning the light on and off. They also came with a hanging kit. As for the bulbs, well, this is where the light excels. You can really use anything that fits in the socket, from LED to CFL. Whatever you choose, it's really up to you. I'm going to cover the benefits of each type later in the video, but I did pick up some smaller CFL lights for about $1 each. So in total, this project only cost $7 per light if I didn't paint it and I used the cheapest bulbs I could find. To install, I drilled a hole large enough to fit the socket of a regular bulb through. I used a step drill so as not to crack the planter. There are a ton of different ways you can go about installing the socket into the planter, and whichever way you pick, just make sure that none of the metal from the bulb actually touches the planter. Really, the metal is the bulb's heat sink and might potentially melt the plastic. With the method I'm using, I ran these bulbs continuously for over 24 hours and had no issues of heating at all. Put the bulb in through the bottom and the socket on the outside. Depending on the thickness of the planter, you may need to trim the socket down a bit. Luckily, these are generally plastic and easy to trim with either a saw or some simple sandpaper. Just make sure you don't trim off too much, or the connection will not be tight. You want the bulb to not only screw tightly into the socket, but also grip the planter firmly so that nothing is moving. All we need to do next is hang it. With my aquarium, it's in a room with ceilings that are only 7 feet tall. I also have drop ceilings with removable panels, so I was kind of lucky in that all I had to do was move the panels out of the way and screw the hook in where I wanted the light to hang, followed by hooking on the cord grip and then the cord. Then I put the panels back in place. Because the ceilings in my office are so low, I wasn't able to take advantage of the on and off switch of the cords, not while hanging the distance I wanted. Now the cords run along the ceiling and into the next room, where I plug them into an extension cord and then into a timer. Obviously, this installation is not what most of you will encounter, but that only means that you have more ways to get creative on how you hang yours. Now on to the types of bulbs and their benefits. We'll cover CFL and LED, the two most popular choices. When it comes to coverage, the LED type does not do as well as the CFL. The CFL covers a much wider light pattern. However, this can be adjusted by simply lowering and raising the light. The further from the tank, the more coverage you get. In this example though, the LED lit a 3-foot diameter, only being 14 inches from the table. The CFL does almost double that at the same distance, but it does fade near the perimeter. So the CFL dominates in coverage. On the aquarium though, the CFL lights up the tank really well. I tried a 26 watt bulb and then a 12 watt bulb. I preferred the lower wattage myself, but it goes to show you that you also have control over the brightness by simply picking a higher or lower wattage. The LED doesn't cast as much of a bright light, but it does make the water shimmer and the fish swimming cast shadows underneath them, which I thought was really cool. Not bad for an 8.5 watt bulb. Of course, you can go brighter if you wanted to. When picking a Kelvin rating, this refers to the color the light will be. Try to pick something between 4500 and 6500 Kelvins. In this example, I was trying 6500 Kelvin CFLs and 5000 Kelvin LED. The higher in the number you go, the bluer the light will get, and the lower the number you go, the more yellow or green the light will get. Another difference between the two will be the cost, the LED generally costing 5 to 10 times as much. However, you do get the shimmer and low wattage. Obviously, if you shop around, you can get them a lot cheaper as well. Now, some of you might be wondering if this light can grow plants, and the short answer is probably not as is. Even though many have had success with LEDs and CFLs, you will need to go with a higher wattage and keep them close to the top of the tank. Personally, I used to use CFL lighting to grow low light plants in the past and had plenty of success, so it's worth a shot. So even though the cheapest route to building this is $7, obviously cost will vary depending on what you pick. In the end, you get a light that you basically get to pick everything for. The shape, size, color, intensity, type of bulb, and of course the color. Plus, changing a bulb is as simple as removing the old one and twisting the new one in. Personally, I'm enjoying this light even though the last light was great as well. I am liking the new look and the fact that the top of my tank is now wide open with nothing in the way. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and I will see you next Sunday for a new do-it-yourself project.